हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू वन मोर वीडियो ऑफ स्पेशल बायोटॉनिक, अ चैनल टू मेक बायोलॉजी सब्जेक्ट इजी। स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस सेशन वी विल टॉक अबाउट रिप्रोडक्शन इन एंजियोस्पर्म पार्ट वन। इफ यू सी द हेडिंग ऑफ दिस टॉपिक केयरफुली, देयर आर टू टर्म्स हियर, वन इज रिप्रोडक्शन एंड सेकेंड इज एंजियोस्पर्म्स। Students, as we all know, there are three types of reproduction. These types are asexual, vegetative, and sexual. So, in this session, we will be mainly focusing on sexual reproduction. Second part of the heading is angiosperms. As we all are familiar with classification of plants, these plants are broadly divided into two groups, cryptogams and phanerogams. Now, cryptogams are further divided into thallophyta, bryophyta and pteridophyta, whereas phanerogams are further divided into gymnosperms and angiosperms. Gymnosperms are the group of plants which produce seeds, but fruits are absent. In angiosperms, the plant shows well-developed flowers, fruits, and seeds. So, in this video, we'll talk about various parts of the flower. Students, in the beginning, I request you all to please do like and share this video and hit the subscribe button to get notification of all my new videos. All right. In angiosperms, sexual reproduction occurs with the help of flower. So, we can define flower as modified stem, which is meant for sexual reproduction. Now, let us talk about various parts of the flower. Students, this is the stalk of the flower. It is called pedicel. This pedicel leads to broader portion called thalamus. This thalamus holds various floral whorls. These floral whorls are of two types, non-essential and essential whorl. Non-essential whorl include calyx and corolla, whereas androecium and gynoecium are essential whorls. Calyx is the first and outermost whorl. Its members are called sepals. It is green, photosynthetic, and protects the inner whorl during bud condition. The second whorl is corolla. Their members are called petals. These petals are colored in nature. So, these colored petals attract pollinators such as birds, insects for pollination. It also protects the inner part of the flower during bud condition. Corolla is followed by two essential whorls, namely androecium and gynoecium. Androecium is the third whorl. Their members are called stamens. Each stamen shows lower filament and upper anther. Stamen produce pollens, which in turn produces male gametes. Last whorl of the flower is gynoecium. Its members are called carpels or pistils. Each carpel is made up of ovary, style and stigma. The function of the carpel is to produce female gamete. This carpel, after fertilization, produces seeds and fruits. Students, we can learn many terms associated with this flower. Now, this flower shows all four whorls, that is, calyx, corolla, androecium, and gynoecium. Therefore, A flower with all four whorls is called complete flower. If one or more whorls are missing, such a flower is called incomplete flower. Again, this flower shows both androecium and gynoecium. So, flower with both androecium and gynoecium is called bisexual flower. In some flowers, such as Cycas papaya, the flower may show either androecium or gynoecium. Such a flower is called unisexual flower. Accordingly, in male flower, androecium is present but gynoecium is absent. These flowers are also called staminate flowers. In female flower, gynoecium is present but androecium is absent. Such flowers are also called pistillate flower. Students, I hope you are clear with the structure of flower. I highly recommend you to take a flower, especially hibiscus or datura, and dissect this flower at home. I am sure you'll understand all these parts of the flower in better way. In the next video, I'll discuss about male gametophyte. So stay home, stay safe. Thank you.